Voiceovers, stop reading scripts. Right, what do I mean by this? Well, I learned this technique decades ago when I worked for the production department of Piccadilly Radio. Now, this was way before the internet and voiceover artists had to come physically into my studio to record. Now, I'd started my own voiceover career and I was in audio production as well, and I was learning from the very best in person. I was very lucky. Now, these voice artists would come into the studio, would have a chat, then would get down to recording, and they would get into position in front of the microphone, holding the then paper script, of course. And suddenly, when we were recording and the red light was on in the studio, these people would intriguingly turn into almost another person in front of me as the tape recorder reeled round. Of course, they weren't just reading the script, they were acting it. Now, many of these fine voices I was working with were trained actors with a great track record on theatre and television, but don't worry, if you are just a voiceover artist, you don't need to regularly tread the boards or be rather trained to be a great voice actor. I'm not, and I get loads of work. It's all about understanding and learning how to quickly get into the zone for each individual script. I'll teach you an easy technique of how to do it in this video. Now, when a professional movie actor or theatre actor gets a part, they won't just learn the lines, turn up on set and read their script from their memory. They'll research the type of person they're playing in the movie and they'll get into the role. So if they're playing a police officer, they'll hang out with the cops, see how they talk, move, react to things. Playing a doctor, they'd observe medical professionals in great detail in their workplace to help them get their role. You get the picture. But hang on, us voiceovers can get a whole load of scripts per day. We haven't got time to do all this palaver. And anyway, we're not talking voice acting, yeah? Like proper acting in video games where we do get to play characters. What about the straightforward promo scripts or commercial radio and TV spots? Well, look, in my opinion, this technique applies to everything, everything. In every script, you can use basic acting skills. So you don't just read the script, you perform it, you act it. Now, I know some clients would be perfectly happy with their scripts being simply read, but if you want to wow your clients and to make their hopefully well-written copy come alive and to win more auditions, importantly, try out this technique. Now, when you get into the right mindset, as well as understanding what the script's about, you'd naturally hit the right emphasis points, you'd naturally give just the right pauses in the right places, and the melody of your narration will sound just right. And you can get into this mindset really quickly before every single script you get given, whether it's a paid job or an audition. Simply try your best, first of all, to understand the script. Understand the script. What's it about? And then answer three questions. One, who am I? Who am I talking? Two, who is my audience? And three, what is my emotion? Let's look at examples. Say you've got a script to be used at a big business conference. It's for a video aimed at potential investors for a set of massive warehouses. Who are you? Well, you are the person who spent years getting this project off the ground. You've put a lot of your personal money into this project. Your house is on the line. You need this investment. You've got to persuade these people. This project has got to succeed. The audience, the investors who are trying to be convinced by you, or maybe not. So your emotion should be one of professional pride in the project. You are excited that the new warehouses will bring new life to the area, create jobs, reap back rewards in the future, and so on and so on. So with this in mind, you can snap into this type of person as you get behind the microphone. Pretend you are on that stage, facing the investors at that all-important conference, and not just in your own little cozy voice booth. So just reading the script, it could sound like this.
In conclusion, investing in our groundbreaking warehouse park is not just about profits, it's about transforming our community. This project goes beyond bricks and mortar. It's a catalyst for economic growth, job creation, and modernized infrastructure. By joining forces, we have the opportunity to shape the future of this region, unlocking its full potential. Thank you for considering this transformative journey with us.
But following the understand and three question method, it could sound much better all round, like this.
In conclusion, investing in our groundbreaking warehouse park is not just about profits, it's about transforming our community. This project goes beyond bricks and mortar. It's a catalyst for economic growth, job creation, and modernized infrastructure. By joining forces, we have the opportunity to shape the future of this region, unlocking its full potential. Thank you for considering this transformative journey with us.
Well, I hope you'll agree it is much more compelling. It sounds like I really care, that I've got passion and professional excitement about this warehouse scheme. But what if you're given a highly technical script or a complex one about a niche that you have absolutely no knowledge whatsoever? How can you possibly understand the script in the first place? Well, look, don't worry. For example, I am not an economics genius, yet I get given many highly complex scripts on that particular subject. People think I'm an expert. Now, even though I don't understand what I'm saying, well, some of it I do, I can still answer the three questions. Who am I? An economics expert. Who is my audience? Other economic experts and the educated public. What is my emotion? A focused mind on the importance of the message. Yeah? Now, with scripts like this, it's all in the words you emphasize and the pauses you leave. So it sounds natural. And it's got to sound like you're ad-libbing rather than just reading. So let's take a clip from an economic script. Just reading it could sound like this.
Essentially, the depreciation of commercial real estate values is placing borrowers in a precarious position, finding themselves upside down as the collateral's worth falls below the loan balance. In simpler terms, swift refinancing becomes a distant possibility. The study suggests that distress in commercial real estate could render smaller regional banks insolvent. This presents a significant and urgent cause for alarm.
But answering the three questions and getting into the right mindset, it could get recorded like this.
Essentially, the depreciation of commercial real estate values is placing borrowers in a precarious position, finding themselves upside down as the collateral's worth falls below the loan balance. In simpler terms, swift refinancing becomes a distant possibility. The study suggests that distress in commercial real estate could render smaller regional banks insolvent. This presents a significant and urgent cause for alarm.
So don't you think that sounds a little better? Look, I hope you find this useful. You may totally disagree with me, but I know this method works for me in both winning auditions against others and in really making clients happy to rebook me in the future. Recently, I had a client who said, "Wow, it sounds like you really understand what we're about here. It looks like you're on our team." Well, of course I would. It's my job. I make it sound like I'm on your team, all right? I'm just acting it. I'm not on your team, but it's a commercial. It's for you, and you deserve the best. That's what I've given you. That's what I told this bloke. Anyway, is this the secret sauce you've been looking for? I hope it's useful. Just use it. So a recap, read through the script, do your best to understand it. All right, understand it, then answer the three questions. Who are you? Who is the audience? What is my emotion? If you'd like further tips and videos on all things voiceover and voice training, please visit voiceovermasterclass.com. That's voiceovermasterclass.com. And thanks for watching. Have a great day in the booth.